Hi everyone, my name is Ashley. Today I am here with a new video which explains early warning score. This video I prepared mainly for those who are planning to come to European countries. The early warning score chart is used in many countries in different names. In India, in some of the hospitals we use MUSE chart, that is modified early warning score chart. In Ireland, we are using the NEWS chart, National Early Warning Score chart. Even we have the PEWSE chart, Pediatric Early Warning Score chart. Even for the maternity, we have the same chart. There are some differences in each charts, but almost in total, if we look into this chart, it is same. So I'll explain you what is this NEWS chart or Early Warning Score chart. So this Early Warning Score chart provides a standardized system for recording routine clinical data for all patients in the hospital. It contains some sections which shows the frequency of monitoring, that is how many times we need to do this chart. And this is mainly helps to identify the early signs of deterioration in patients' conditions and helps to identify more timely medical review and treatment for patients with the help of this escalation protocol in this chart. So now let's see how can we use this NEWS chart or early warning score chart. At the moment I have a pediatric early warning score chart. I'll show you how to use this. So this is how the PEWS chart looks like. So on top you can see the chart date, we have to write when we are starting to use this chart, and next is the patient details, surname, forename, address, HCR number is the number of the patients which we are giving when the patient is admitted in the hospital, the date of birth and the consultant. And again on top we can see parameter amendment. So this is mainly done by the doctors. If we are finding a high score, we need to inform the doctor and the doctors will do which parameter to be amended. Then the core parameters in this side, that is airway and breathing, then circulation, then comes to D for disability, E for exposure. Then again we can see the year of the year, when in which year we are starting this thing, the date on top we have to write which date we are doing it, the time and the frequency of observations. So usually we do the observations every 4 hourly if the patient's condition is normal, and if we are finding any kind of any deterioration in those cases we do it according to the condition of the patient. So those all things it is given in the chart itself, how many hours interval we need to do it. Then next is clinician or family concern indicate and score of 1. So if the patient, family members, or if we are concerned, we have to put the score 1. Then we'll start with the parameters. The first one is airway and breathing. So in airway and breathing we can see we need to monitor the respiratory rate, respiratory effort, oxygen therapy and the saturation. So the respiratory rate, this PEWSE chart mainly is using for children above 12 years. So we can see the respiratory rate 10 to 35 and the normal rate is between 15 to 20. So if we are getting a respiratory rate between 15 to 20, we need to put a dot in that. So you can see in the one I have put a dot in that one. So we'll write the respiratory rate. Suppose if it is 18, we need to write it as 18, and the score will be 0, because this white color which indicates 0 on top we had seen already, white is 0. The parameters, this or the score which comes in yellow is score 1, the score which is coming in 2 is in blue color, and the score which we are getting, a higher score if you are getting, which goes into the pink, that is 3. Then the next is the respiratory effort. So the respiratory effort, which can be normal, mild, moderate or severe. So if the patient has normal respiratory effort, we'll put it as in the white color and we'll put the score 0. And if the patient has any kind of mild problems, like any of the stridor on exertion, or any respiratory rate is mildly increased, or mild intercostal recession or suprasternal recession, in those cases we'll put it as 1, that is in the score 1 which goes. Then again, if there is any moderate kind, so it which goes into the blue color, that is, for example, like if the patient has mild stridor at rest or moderate intercostal and suprasternal recession or nasal flaring, those cases we'll put the score into the blue one and it is moderate. And again, severe will be coming in if the patient has stridor at rest, or if the patient has marked intercostal or suprasternal recession, or respiratory rate is in pink zone. So all those cases comes in the severe case. Then the third is oxygen therapy. So in the oxygen therapy, we need to see whether the patient breathe in normal room air, or if the patient needs a support with the oxygen. If the patient needs support with the oxygen, we need to see whether it is less than or equal to 2 liters, or is it more than 2 liters. If it is less than 2 liters, we need to give the score 1, that is which comes in the yellow one. And if it goes into the blue one, if the patient is getting more than 2, then we need to put the dot in the blue one and we need to put the score as 2, because blue color indicates score 2. Then the last one in the airway and breathing is saturation. So the normal saturation is considered as above 94%. The score above 94% falls into score 0, which comes in the white one. Then if the patient has the saturation rate 90 to 93%, which goes into the yellow one. If the saturation rate is 86 to 89%, which goes into blue one. And if it is less than 85%, which goes into the pink one. So based on that, we'll put the score again. So if the patient has got the score 98, it is into the 0. Then again, next is the circulation. So in the circulation, mainly we use 3 things. First one is heart rate. Second is central capillary refill time. This is mainly used only in children, not in the adult cases. Then the blood pressure. So the heart rate for children about 12 years, we are considering 60 to 100 is the normal range. Any rate which comes in 60 to 100, we'll put the dot in the white one and we'll write the score in the lower part. Then if the heart rate above 100, that is 100 to 110, which gives a score 1 because it is in the yellow color. And if the heart rate above 120 to 140, again it gives score 2 because it comes in the blue color. And above 140 is the severe one, the danger one, that is in the pink color. Same way, we can see the lower heart rate below 60, that is in between 40 to 60, we give a yellow color, and which is score 1. And directly below 40, it is severe zone, so which gives a score 3. So we need to write the point based on that. Then the central capillary refill time. So the central capillary refill time, which is mainly done by pressing the sternum. So within how many seconds the refill time is. So if it is less than or equal to 2, which gives a score 0. And if it is more than 2, which is score 1. Then the blood pressure. So the blood pressure, here we give more importance for the systolic blood pressure. So for the systolic blood pressure, we have to see if it comes between 110 to 120. So this is the normal for a child about 12 years. So if it is between 110 to 120, we are giving a score 0. We are not checking the diastolic pressure.
we need to mark it. Like here I have put 112 to 56, 112 by 656. So here we are marking it, but mainly we are checking the systolic blood pressure. So the systolic blood pressure score is 0. Then the next thing is skin color. So in the skin color, we have 4 options here: pink, mottled, pale and cyanosed. So if you are finding the condition of the patient or the child, if it's pink, then we put it as PK, and if there is mottled, M, P for pale and C for cyanosed. Then the next is disability. So in disability, we are checking the AVPU score. So AVPU score means A for alert, B for voice, P for pain and U for unresponsiveness. So if the patient or the child is alert, we need to put it in the white area. So A, alert, so and gives a score of 0. And if the child or the patient is responding only to our voice, so in that case it goes to the yellow one, and we may have to do the GCS as well. Then the pink comes in pain, only with the pain if the patient or the child is responding, which is in the pink. And same way, unresponsiveness, which comes in the pink one. Then the last one, E for exposure, that is temperature we need to monitor here. So the temperature, if it goes below 36 or if it goes above 38.5 degree, then we need to consider sepsis. So we need to monitor that as well here. And this is the other side of the chart. So on top again we can see in the right hand side the patient's details we need to write, and in the left hand side event record for PU score above 6. So how many times the patient has got the PU score of above 6. So in those cases we need to write it, the date, the time, what was the score, and the nurse's initials and NMBI number, and need to alert, okay, whom we have informed. Then the assessment of respiratory effort, which I already told you, so all the details are given in this. Then the pain score, which we can add here, we can see based on the flag sail. Then AVPU response, so in the AVPU response, all those things, what action we need to do, if suppose the patient is awake, aroused and alert, in that case no action is required. In the case V, voice, if the patient is responding to voice, what action is required. And in the case of P, patient respond to pain. So everything is given in this side. Then the other side of the chart, same way it is given the patient's details, the escalation guide. So in the escalation guide, score 1, score 2, score 3, 4 to 5, 6 and more than 7. So it is given how many times we need to do the observation. So if you are getting a score 1, we need to do the observation every 4 hourly, and we need to inform the nurse in charge. And the response is, any trigger should prompt increase in observation frequency as clinically appropriate. And if you are getting the score 2, we need to do this chart every 2 to 4 hourly. Same way we need to inform the nurse in charge. Then if you're getting a score 3, so any score which is above 3, which is very very important, so here we need to monitor every hourly, need to inform the nurse in charge plus doctor on call. Nurse in charge needs to review, and urgent medical review also is required. Then 4 to 5, same way, nurse in charge, urgent medical review. Score 6, continuous monitoring is required, need to inform nurse in charge, doctor on call, senior doctor or consultant if it is required. So here response is urgent senior medical review. Then if the score is above 7 or 7, again same, continuous call, urgent PU call, immediate local response team. And again, if the score, any one score, if it is above 3, or 3. In that case, we need to inform the doctors. So the next thing is how to inform the doctor. So for that, we are using ISBAR communication tool that I'll explain in the next slide or next video. Hope you all have understood what is a chart and how to use it. Thank you.